Let us pray. Oh my God, incline your ear and hear. Open your eyes and see our desolations and the city that is called by your name. For we do not present our pleas before you because of our righteousness, but because your great mercy. O Lord, hear. O Lord, forgive. O Lord, pay attention and act. Delay not for your own sake, O my God, because your city and your people are called by your name. Gracious and merciful God, we humbly ask you to listen to our requests of your people of Houston Antioch Church. We pray that these find you well and that your blessings will be poured out upon these topics and that we will be filled with your spirit to better worship and follow after you. Father, we pray that our old habits and man-made institutions are destroyed and that true and pure worship and devotion to you returns. That beyond ceremony, beyond ritual, beyond routine, that sincere dedication to you and your word endures. Lord God, please root us in love for you and love for our neighbors. For your word is breathed by you and essential for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training. Let us be wholly devoted to this alone. Father, may we be singularly and comprehensively united under your word, that the world will be moved and encouraged and motivated by your word. Lord, guide us always. Give our pastoral staff and church leadership true wisdom to see with the truest of holy eyes and to not be clouded or deceived by the secular world. May we, the body of Christ, be faithful to strengthen and lifting up one another to ensure no one falls. Let us look outward as much as we look inward. Let the personal goals to better self to lead to communal goals to better all those around. Teach us not to withhold the blessings of your gospel, but instead to share with all those in need. Precious Creator, the days turn over and we approach a new season. Spring is upon us and the rain is over and gone. The flowers appear on the earth. The time for singing has come and the voice of the turtle dove is heard in our land. The fig tree ripens its fruit and the vines are in blossom. They give forth fragrance. This is a time of preparation, an eager anticipation for the coming Easter, the coming time of celebration, of rebirth, renewal, revival, resurrection. Allow us to long to remember and dwell on this annual holy day, but to also rejoice in this every moment of our being. Again, Lord, we come to you, for from you flow all blessings. Through your grace and mercy, we find victory. Thus, hear this prayer, hear the cries of your people, and be gracious unto us. In the wonderful blood, death, rising, and return of Christ, we pray. Amen.